Alright, I'm pulling out the big guns for this one. This will most likely be a two-parter, or it will be a really long video. Spoiler alert, it's a two-parter! So, every enemy has its own bit of lore, so I'm gonna talk about every single enemy in Hollow Knight. This also includes an explanation of all the bosses, because they are also considered enemies. Don't expect a super in-depth dive on the bosses, though. So, this is all the enemies in Hollow Knight, explained. I will be talking about them in the order that they appear in on the wiki. Crawlids are timid scavengers that crawl through the crossroads and the King's Pass. They're the first enemy you encounter and are super weak. They're considered pathetic and dull, and the hunter says they're hardly worth killing. The Dreamnail dialogue shows that it's very hungry, and it makes it in pain. It thinks it's safe in the dark and is in danger in the light, which could mean it's afraid from the radiance, but I don't think it has the mind for that. Vengeflies are flying predators that are considered to be fierce little hunters that bravely chase down creatures that are many times its size. The hunter says that it has killed many in its life and claims it is brave but very weak, kind of like a mosquito in real life. It has some similar Dreamnail dialogue to the Crawlids. It says that they want to kill and hunt in order to get food. They normally hang out in cave areas, which makes sense, because it likes the darkness. The Vengefly King is a bigger version of the Vengefly, and it screeches to call Vengefly reinforcements. It chews on old things it finds on the cavern floor, which would explain why you find Zote in its jaws. The Dreamnail dialogue shows that it is filled with rage and wants to kill and defend, which most likely means he is trying to protect his kin. Gruzzers are simple-minded creatures that just kind of fly around. They don't ever attack you, they just kind of hit you when they fly into you. The hunter says that they aren't really aware of their surroundings and that makes them easy to prey on. Gruzzmother is a matured version of the Gruzzer enemy that is carrying baby Gruzzers in its belly. It attacks by throwing itself at enemies. It doesn't lay eggs, it carries the young in its stomach, which makes it very sleepy and vulnerable. The Dreamnail dialogue states that the Gruzzmother is almost ready to birth the baby Gruzzers, and that it notices that it is in danger while fighting you. Tick-Ticks have sharp claws that help it move around walls and roofs. They are quite peaceful, and they just kind of walk around. They are similar to Crawlids in the fact that they don't really try to kill you, they just kind of walk around. Aspid hunters spit its corrosive spray at you. That could be infection, but the fact that the hunter calls it a corrosive liquid, so it might be just a normal thing that they produce. They often travel in packs and pick you off from a distance. Aspid mothers carry eggs inside their bodies that can hatch when needed in order to deal with intruders. It uses its own youth as a weapon against people. What amazing parents. They're like the Pale King. A very large Aspid Mother can be seen in the glowing womb arena, and it gives the Dreamnail dialogue breed, which could mean it ended up breeding so much that it became huge. Aspid hatchlings swarm around intruders and are recently birthed. They are born with an instinct to kill and are extremely weak because they were just born. Gomes are thickly armored and cannot take damage. They burst out of the ground and seize prey with its fangs. The hunter says that you can sharpen weapons on the skin of the creatures. You can slash them for fun, and they won't even feel a thing. You find a fossil in the crossroads, which is buried deep in the ground. This might mean they are spread throughout the world of Hollow Nest, or the corpses just get buried. Wandering husks are the reanimated corpses of bugs. Infection had the ability to bring these corpses back to life. They used to be a civilized bug who most likely carried Geo and other things in order to do normal person things like buying stuff. The Dreamnail dialogue makes it sound like they are still conscious, saying things like, "Get away from me," or "Your smell, kill you." Husk horn heads are pretty much the same as the wandering husks, except they have a horn that allows them to move faster. Leaping husks just jump at you, and that's really the only difference. Husk bullies are more passive and will only really attack you when you come in range. Husk guards are like regular husks, but they are larger and stronger than their brothers. They steal their weapons from other corpses. They stand at guard waiting for people that wander near. The Dreamnail dialogue points to it being at guard at all times, and it seems like it was trying to protect something at all times. Some of them are in the Fog Canyon and they are dead. Those ones are tired and drained. Entombed husks are mummified versions of corpses that are infected. The hunter says that he looked in the corpse and saw something shining back, something terrible. The False Knight is a maggot who stole the mighty Hegemul's armor in order to keep his siblings safe. The hunter says that he is a weak creature who stole the strength of others and a yearn to dominate those who have dominated them. He found Hegemul sleeping and stole his armor. He eventually fell to the infection's control. His Dreamnail dialogue shows how he thinks he is stronger than everyone. The failed champion is most likely what the False Knight thinks he truly is. The maggots are fat little creatures that are extremely cute and are very weak, as well as the False Knight's siblings. The hunter likes to roast them on a fire. Wow, that's like a slightly less version of, like, eating grubs. Menderbug is a member of a guild of maintenance workers that fix things. This special Menderbug loves his job and fixes one certain sign in the Forgotten Crossroads. His diary shows that he loves his job and enjoys the company of other Menderbugs. Life seeds are little creatures that are filled with lifeblood. They run away when you get close to them. The hunter says that the lifeblood inside of them is delicious. When you have the Joni's Blessing charm equipped, they will come towards you, most likely meaning that they trust you. Balders are little creatures that roll towards you and are aggressive when born. The hunter says that the younger hunters will catch them and roll around them for sport. Elder balders are the grown version of the balders. They are too old and big to jump around and roll. They curl up to cover themselves with their shells in order to protect themselves from weapons. They only have the ability to protect themselves and others, but that's about it. Moss creeps are small creatures that cover themselves in leaves in order to appear larger. The hunter thinks that they were just plants. They are kind of like tick-ticks and crawlids. They are very passive and don't really try to kill you. Moss flies are similar to the moss creeps, except they have wings. The hunter says that they spend their entire life either hiding or fleeing. Mosskin are plant-like creatures that were created by the higher being, Un. The Dreamnail dialogue shows that they are slowly dying because one of them says, "Our leaves wilt," which most likely references the infection. The volatile mosskin is a similar creature to the mosskin, except it is infected more. The hunter claims that the infection smells sweet, and it will burn you if it gets too close. I've never seen anyone using this fact in other videos. Maybe the sweet smell is what draws people near. Bool eaters are carnivorous plants that snap at anyone who goes too close to it. It doesn't seem to be a true living being because the Dreamnail dialogue is just three dots. Squits are similar to Vengeflies, where they fly towards you, except the squit uses a needle-like nose to charge at you. The hunter doesn't really have anything to say about this. Obbles are fat, slow-flying bugs that shoot liquid acid that is stored in its round body. The hunter says they are very annoying while drifting around and spilling its acid everywhere. Gulkas are plants that retract when danger is near, and it spits spiky orbs at you. They apparently taste terrible, but the venom inside the orbs tastes delicious. I have no clue how that makes sense, but I'm not going to judge if you like the taste of venom. Also, similar to the Fool Eaters, they're just plants, not creatures. Mask flies are harmless and will travel in flocks. They are like the birds of Greenpath. They all move together, and when one flies away, the rest do as well. Also, Scurry committed mask fly genocide in his 45-hour speedrun video. Moss chargers are small, timid creatures that frighten intruders away by covering themselves with massive amounts of moss. It feels very strong when it covers itself in all the moss clumps. Similar to the False Knight, it feels stronger when it's protected by armor. The massive moss charger, or the massive miserable cucumber if you like Rusty, is a family of creatures that learned how to bulk up using moss, and they learned how to live as one. The hunter says there is strength in numbers, but it doesn't have much strength to begin with. I want to know why the moss chargers in their moss form have infected eyes, but the little bugs are normal. This doesn't really make sense to me. The Moss Knights are the protectors of Greenpath. They are trained in the ways of the Nail and Shell. They always hide as bushes, and then they pop out to attack. You can find the Lone Moss Knight, who is getting called by Un. They want to kill Light for Un, which means that they want to kill infected bugs so Un can take control once more. The Mossy Vagabonds, or Big Thickness, if you watch Quinbobin, they are said to be lazy and easily swayed by others, which makes sense because you find them at the Moss Prophet's area. They get consumed by the infection because the Moss Prophet most likely taught them about the Radiance. They are also most likely engorged Moss Knights because they are the same height and size, and the elves talk about them as Moss Knights. Durandus are simple walking creatures that roam around through acid and have sharp shells similar to the gomes. It is one of the only creatures that can survive the acid. Durandus are the flying version of the Durandus, and they have spiky shells and is protected by its shell. The Alubas are passive flying creatures that are drawn towards powerful creatures. That's why you see some over by Un and the White Lady. Charged Lumaflies are creatures that generate electricity when something threatens them. They usually drift around, and when they get close together, they shock. It seems like Monomon was researching these creatures because you find the entry for them in a tank filled with them. Wait, how do you pronounce this? Ubuma? Oma? Yuma. I think that's how you say it. Anyway, this is a small jellyfish that is in some way connected to Monomon the teacher. The hunter isn't sure what it actually is. He says, the spirit of a dead ancestor? The brain of a larger creature? Allowed to drift free? So we really have no clue what it is. Umas are the bigger version of the previous enemy. They have some sort of exploding egg or brain or something like that. The hunter says that they are made up of a thick liquid, so maybe it's made from honey or maple syrup or something like that. Umu is a huge jellyfish creature. It guards Monomon the teacher. The hunter says that the canyon gives off very thick fog, but it's crackling with some sort of strange energy. It is an intelligent but infected creature. The Dreamnail dialogue shows that the creature wants to protect Monomon at all costs. Amblooms are small, simple-minded fungus creatures with a spiked top. The legs seem to be the stem of the mushroom. They seem to be quite simple creatures that just kinda wanna walk around. Funglings are very adorable fungus balloons that have internal gases that cause it to float. It just drifts around because it's a child. The hunter gives us one of the most interesting pieces of information about himself in the journal entry. He used to hunt his own siblings, and now he hunts alone. I mean, that's kind of your problem, bud. Fungoons are the adult version of the funglings that can spit up the internal gas inside, which allows it to deal damage. The hunter just calls them very round. Hunter, you're so useless sometimes. Sports have the ability to detect nearby movement, and then they shoot an explosion spore. I'm assuming they can detect the vibrations that you make while stepping on the ground. They're one of the enemies in this game that are just a plant. Nothing more, nothing less. Just plant. Fungified husks are corpses that were consumed by the fungus around it. The infection most likely reanimated them after the fungus spread onto their corpses. The fungus gives them the ability to release infected spore clouds. They act similar to the spore shroom charm. Shroomlings are yet another infant fungal creature that just kind of runs away and bumps into things. When it senses danger, it uproots and flees. They most likely use their mushroom body to blend in and avoid danger. Shroomal Warrior, aka the funny mushroom guy who goes wah! They attack to protect the shroomlings, and they release spore clouds when they roll around. When you look back at the old trailer, the Weird and Wonderful World trailer, you can see one of these warriors carrying a staff with the light seed on the end. In the trailer, when you talk to him, he seems to have gone crazy, saying stuff like, "Ooh, such glorious wonder, such regal brilliance. I must be near it. How I want to smell it, touch it." Like, what the heck is that supposed to mean? Shroomal ogres are huge fungal creatures that spit up some sort of corrosive venom, which is most likely infection goop. The hunter cut one open inside to find it was a beast or mushroom. He found nothing but a soft inside. It says stuff in its Dreamnail dialogue that further proves that the mushrooms work as one mind, saying things like, "We crush, we strong, and we as one." they use the word we, which naturally means multiple. Mantis youth are the youngest members of the mantis tribe and protect their territory using its needle. Judging by the Dreamnail dialogue, it wants to kill us in order to prove its strength to the tribe and that it wants to teach us fear, and for some reason it calls us a mighty warrior and an accepted creature after we beat the mantis lords. Mantis warriors are the grown version of the mantis youth, who use their limbs as weapons rather than using them as some form of stinger. The Dreamnail dialogue shows how they honored the lords and that all intruders shall perish, and that they resist the infection with nothing except their will. They also talk about how no more will fall, and that no more will be an outcast, which probably refers to the traitor lord and his followers, who took in the infection willingly to become stronger, and then they were outcasted. The Mantis Lords are the proud leaders of the Mantis Tribe. They are three sisters who rule over the Mantis Tribe together with pride and honor. They cast out their brother, who took in the infection willingly to gain strength. They have kept the beasts of Deepnest at bay, and kept them in their territory. The Mantis Lords didn't want to join the king, so they just kinda did their own thing. They see us as a true challenger, and they think that you are a true opponent in battle. The Husk Sentry is an animated remains of an old sentry, and it still performs the same tasks it used to. It is considered to be better at combat than most bugs. They most likely stopped people from coming into the city when it locked its gates. The Dreamnail dialogue helps prove that they wanted to keep outsiders out, saying things like defend, kill, protect the city, not welcome, kill, and keep out. The Heavy Sentries are animated remains of a large sentry. Go figure! The hunter says that's surprisingly quick-witted. It has basically the same as the regular sentry, except it got pumped up with steroids or something like that. The Wing Sentries use their bug powers to grow wings and fly. They also say RAVA when they attack you. Wow, the Pale King must have spent a lot of money on these sentry guys. This is the fourth guy! I mean, I guess he does like spikes, and they do use spikes. Anyway, this guy just has a larger spear, and that's the only difference. Mistakes were once highly intelligent bugs that were deformed by the misuse of soul. The scholars of the Soul Sanctum used these bugs as test subjects, and then they turned into these guys. The Dreamnail dialogue shows how they are in pain and are in denial, saying things like, did it work, and why? Why? Follies are basically just mistakes that have the ability to float around. Oh, the Soul Twisters, the third worst enemy in the entire game. Anyway, these guys are some of the scholars of the Soul Sanctum. They use their knowledge to twist soul and cast spells. The infection gets put into their soul, that's why it causes the orange color in the soul blasts. The Soul Warrior is a bug that enhances its combat with the power of soul. It is one of the scholars of the Soul Sanctum that has a very hazy grasp on its own memories and the origin of its powers. The Dreamnail dialogue shows how it isn't sure what is actually happening. It doesn't know where the soul came from, and it doesn't know the cost of its powers. The Soul Master is the head of the Soul Sanctum. It hoarded soul hoping to become immortal and hoping to save Hollow Nest from the infection. But it became intoxicated by its power. It tried to find a way to give bugs the ability to attain pure focus. The Pale King opposed his work, and the Master failed to realize that the infection was the thing that was influencing him. He drained the soul from the soul totems and the poor bugs. All the corpses in the Soul Master Phase 2 arena were subjects to the soul drain. The Husk Dandies were former members of the higher class of Hollow Nest, so basically, they were rich boys. They are very greedy and weak. The Dreamnail dialogue shows how greedy they are, saying, "This wealth, mine all mine, and you want my Geo?" The Cowardly Husk is basically the Husk Dandy, except it will use the old instincts to run away from danger. There is one up inside Lurian's room, and the files call it Watcher's Butler, so it's safe to assume that that's what this one was. The Gluttonous Husk is a husk that, as it got wealthier, it stayed inside more and ate more and became so fat. It throws its body at you as a weapon, which I find weird considering how much that would hurt. Imagine throwing all your body weight at something wielding a nail. The gorgeous husk still has the instincts to carry Geo, and that's why it has so much money in its pockets. The Hunter Journal says that it is encrusted with shining metal, which could mean it's not of just a former bug, it could be a living gold statue or something like that, I don't know. Great Husk Sentries are the animated remains of the Great Sentry, which were some of the most elite guards in the city. Similar to the Sentries, they still walk their posts and keep guard on the city. The Watcher Knights suck. Nobody likes these guys, but I guess I have to talk about them. Some sort of infected fly is what causes them to be reanimated. They died while standing guard in the spire, but like the other husks, these guys don't get reanimated with the power of infection. Are you or a loved one dead? Try the infection. Only 17 small payments of $19.99. Warning, use of infection may cause complete loss of will or mind. Use at your own risk. The Collector is a creature made of void, possibly a failed king's mold or something made by the Pale King to keep the grubs in jars. It loves to capture things and put them in jars, but it mainly puts grubs in jars. The Dreamnail dialogue shows how he loves to put things in jars. Well, at least it's happy about its job or hobby. Maybe it wants to save the grubs from the infection, and they thought this was the best way to do it. Jars. The Bellflies use the infection in their bodies in order to dive bomb things. It has no regard for its life, so it just kind of blows stuff up. Pillflips are creatures that adapt to its situation by flipping over and using its limbs on the other side of its body. Having this ability allows them to survive easily because adaptability is very important. Anyway, that concludes your science lesson with Mr. Starwatcher. Wurmps are funny little creatures that swell when threatened, and the Hunter once again has some amazing input here. Extremely amusing creature. Hunter, 2017. Blug sacks are disgusting creatures that give you the best item in the entire game. Rancid Eggs! The Dung Defender is one of the five great knights. He is unaware that all of his friends are dead. He still believes that they are alive and well. He fights for honor and loyalty. Ogrim survived the infection by hiding himself in the royal waterways. In the White Defender fight, when Dreamnailed, he gives some sad dialogue about him missing his friends, saying, Hegemul, I miss your humor. Zamir, I miss your stories. Drya, I miss your wisdom. And Yzma, I miss you. The Defender is one of my favorite characters because of his in-depth lore. The Fluke Fays are the youngest of the species and are composed of teeth, wings, and a stomach. It wants to latch onto any living thing that comes near it. The Flukemons are worm-like creatures that like damp and dark areas. For some reason, when you kill them, it splits in half and starts attacking you more. The Flukemarm is the mother of the Flukes, and it has the desire to breed. She can't leave her cave because of her position as breeder. It was infected, turning it and her children hostile. And she's considered to be alluring in the Hall of God's description, so, that's a thing. So, that's the end of part one. Hope you learned some new stuff, and, I guess, have a good one and sweet dreams. Man, I'm not good at outros.